Hello learners, myself Mona Malhotra. Today I am going to give my presentation on speaking skill. Now let's come to our topic, what is communication? The process of communication is what allows us to interact with other people. Without it, we would be unable to share knowledge or experiences with anything outside of ourselves. Common forms of communication include speaking, writing, gestures, touch, and broadcasting. Now we will discuss about language. What is language basically? Language is a tool for communication. We communicate with others to express our ideas and to know others' ideas as well. Communication takes place where there is speech. Without speech, we cannot communicate with one another. The importance of speaking skills, hence, is enormous for the learners of any language. Without speech, a language is reduced to a mere script. The use of language is an activity which takes place within the confines of our community. We use language in a variety of situations. People at their workplaces, researchers working either in a medical laboratory or in a language laboratory, are supposed to speak correctly and effectively in order to communicate well with one another. Any gap in communication results in misunderstandings and problems. Now, it's a very beautiful definition has been given by Jesperson. Language is a set of human habits, the purpose of which is to give expression to thoughts and feelings. Learning of a language is a skill subject. Every skill requires a lot of practice. So, in the teaching learning of English, the four main skills are listening, speaking, reading, and writing. Now here are top 10 global affairs, and the pie chart is showing that fears. Among these, maximum global fear is 19%, that is of public speaking, 16% is of death, 13% is from spiders or bugs, 12% is from heights, 11% is from social situations, 7% from flying, 5% from open spaces, 4% from storms, and 3% from small spaces. So, the maximum global fear among people is 19%, and that is public speaking. So, let's talk about speech. C.C. Fries has defined it in a very good way. The speech is the language. Same as Leach and Swarthik has defined it. An important element of communicative approach is a student's ability to use and understand the spoken language. Now, what is speaking? Speech is the vocalized form of human communication. Speech production takes place in real time and it is linear, that is, utterance by utterance. Planning is severely limited, therefore, it is the hardest of all four skills. Now, speaking. It is the process of building and sharing meaning through the use of verbal and non-verbal symbols in a variety of context. Speaking is a skill, just like swimming, driving a car, or playing ping pong. One fundamental difference is between knowledge and skill is that both can be understood and memorized, but only a skill can be imitated and practiced. Further, speaking skill is the art of communications and one of four productive skills that must be mastered in learning foreign language. Good speaking skills is the act of generating words that can be understood by listeners. A good speaker is clear as well as informative. Speech skills have two major components. First one is motor perception skill, wherein the learner of a foreign language is exposed to sounds and structures of the target language, which the learner perceives, recalls, and articulates in the correct order. And other one is interaction skill. As the learner progresses through various listening speaking contexts, he or she begins to reach a level where the foreign language is merged as if were the situation, and the learner begins to think in the language. Now let's discuss about importance of speaking skills. The first is ability to convey your information in a proper way. Business managers, educators, military leaders, lawyers, politicians, among others, seek to develop their speaking skills to such a level that they are transformed into master communicators. Speaking clearly and confidently can gain the attention of an audience, providing the golden opportunity for the speaker to make the message known. Second one is ability to stand out from the rest. When one thinks of speaking skills, one tends to think of it as a common skill. Think again, the ability to stand before others and speak effectively is not an ordinary ability. Many people are deathly afraid of public speaking. Others have little ability to form thoughts into sentences and then deliver those words in a believable way. Third one is ability to benefit derivatively. Well-developed verbal skills can increase one's negotiation skills. Self-confidence is improved. A growing sense of comfort comes from speaking in front of larger and larger audiences. A reputation for excellence in speaking can accrue over time, thereby imparting a certain credibility to the speaker. And the next one is career enhancement. Employers have always valued the ability to speak well. It is and always will be an important skill and well worth the effort in fully developing. Speaking skills are important for career success, but certainly not limited to one's professional aspirations. Speaking skills can enhance one's personal life, thereby bringing about the well-rounded growth we should all seek. Now let's discuss about English sound systems. There are 26 letters and 44 sounds. There is an alphabet or symbol for each. These symbols have been given by International Phonetic Association, that is IPA. English sounds can be divided into vowel sounds and consonant sounds. Now let's discuss about vowel. Vowel is a speech sound in which the mouth is open and the tongue is not touching the top of the mouth, the teeth, etc. A definition given by Oxford Learner's Dictionary. And other one given by Cambridge Learner's Dictionary, that is, vowel is a speech sound produced by humans when the breath flows out through the mouth without being blocked by the teeth, tongue or lips. Now vowel sounds. Voice sounds in the production of which there is no obstruction, partial or complete, the result will be a vowel sound. Although there are five vowels, that is A, E, I, O, U, but there are 20 vowel sounds which have been classified as first pure vowel sounds that are 12 in number and diphthongs that are 8 in number. Pure vowel is a single vowel sound, that is, for example, cat, bat, letter, better. Pure vowels which are 12 in numbers are classified as long vowels and short vowels. Long vowels are 5 in number and short vowels are 7 in number. Let's talk about diphthongs, which are 8 in number. It is a combination of two vowel sounds pronounced as a single syllable. It is a glide from one vowel to another. They are also called impure vowel sounds because they do not have the purity of one sound. Example, toy, voice, tour, poor. This is all about diphthongs. Now consonant sounds, English spelling system has 24 consonants in all. Now let's talk about voice and voiceless sounds. Most ordinary speech sounds contain either breath or voice. Which contain voice are called voice sounds, that is V, Z, B, etc. Which contain breath are called voiceless sounds, F, S, etc. Now phoneme. A phoneme is a minimum unit of sound of a particular language which human beings are able to produce, that is P, G, R, S, K, Q, T, etc. are the phonemes of English language. In English, we have 44 phonemes. Let's talk about syllable. A syllable is the next higher unit of speech. In a language, separate phonemes like H, P are not spoken. We use these phonemes in a group. in the manner they occur in a word. A word is made up of syllables, and syllables are made of phonemes. As a syllable is a unit of organization for a sequence of speech sounds. For example, the word water is composed of two syllables, wa and ter. A syllable is typically made up of a syllable nucleus, most often a vowel, with optional initial and final margins, typically consonants. So, syllables are often considered as the phonological building blocks of words. They can influence the rhythm of a language, its prosody, its poetic meter, and its stress patterns. Now, what is stress? The prominence of syllables in words in speech is called stress. The stress syllable in English is a little longer and louder than others. So, here the voice is the heaviest in a word or a sentence. It is shown by a vertical stroke placed above the stressed syllable. This emphasis is typically caused by such properties as increased loudness and vowel length, full articulation of the vowel, and changes in pitch. The stress placed on syllables within words is called word stress or lexical stress. The stress placed on words within sentences is called sentence stress or prosodic stress. Let's talk about rhythm. Generally, rhythm can never be talked about without referring to stress. It is simply the flow or regularity of the stress in a sentence. It is in fact very significant characteristic of English speech. English language has stress time rhythm. That means an equal amount of time elapses between one stress syllable and the next, no matter how many or how few unstressed syllables may come in between. For example, Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. Now, let's discuss about intonation. The rise and fall of pitch in voice is intonation. In other words, intonation is the variation in pitch. It is won by slacking or tightening our vocal cords and the sound. In pronunciation, intonation is very important. Now, types of intonation. There are two types of intonation, falling intonation as well as rising intonation. So, let's talk about falling intonation. Here, we start speaking with a loud pitch of voice and the voice goes down. The pitch of the voice falls on the most important syllable. This type of intonation is definite and conclusive one. For example, sit down. What a nice idea. Now, rising intonation. Here we start with a low pitch of voice and then the voice goes up. The pitch of the voice rises on the most important syllable. For example, are you coming? Do me a favor, please. Now, let's talk about fluency. Fluency means saying word groups with no gaps or hesitation in the middle. It means words should be spoken without stumbling over the words and sequence of sounds. Next one is pause. Pause means to stop for a while. In English language, speaker should give a pause after a comma or full stop. The pause can change the entire meaning of a sentence. For example, girls read nicely. Girls read nicely. So, clear, we can see the difference between the two sentences. Now, what does speaking involve? Knowing and using the following in order to convey intended meaning, speaking involves appropriate vocabulary and expressions, correct pronunciation, correct word order, body language, tone, and facial expressions. Now, why students make errors? Let's discuss this topic. There are many reasons, including in this topic. First one is interference of mother tongue speech habits. Second one is lack of exposure. Third one, lack of teacher. Fourth is lack of attention to English pronunciation. Fifth one is lack of knowledge of intonation and stress. Sixth is crowded classroom. And seventh is lack of curriculum emphasis on speaking skills. Now here are some suggestions for good pronunciation. It means what we should do to improve our pronunciation. The first is, opportunities should be given so that learners can speak and can get feedback. Second is, audio-visual aids can be useful. Next is, environment must be congenial. Next is, individual drill and chorus drill both should be given. Next, English should not be taught with the help of mother tongue. Next one is, correct speech habits should be encouraged. Moreover, learners should be helped to know the functioning of speech organs in correct pronunciation and how to follow them. And learners can be encouraged to watch TV shows, plays, dramas and BBC channels. Thus, for proper pronunciation, a good knowledge of sound system, stress, rhythm, intonation, fluency and pause are needed. So, next is what to do before speaking. What are the things we should keep in mind before speaking? First, be an active listener. Second is, be a quick organizer of thoughts. And third is, structure your speech in mind. It means we should keep the things in our mind before speaking. Now, here are some micro skills. First is to pronounce the distinct sounds. Second is, use the correct form of words. Third one, put words together in correct word order. Next is, use vocabulary appropriately. Fifth, use the language that is appropriate. Now, there are some kinds of speaking situations in which we find ourselves. First is interactive, next is partially interactive, and third one is non-interactive. Interactive speaking situations include face-to-face conversations and telephone calls, in which we are alternatively listening and speaking, and in which we have a chance to ask for clarification, repetition, or slower speech from our conversation partner. Next, some speaking situations are partially interactive, such as when giving a speech to a live audience, where the convention is that the audience does not interrupt the speech. The speaker nevertheless can see the audience and judge from the expressions on their faces and body language whether or not he or she is being understood. And the last one is, some few speaking situations may be totally non-interactive, such as when recording a speech for a radio broadcast. Now, with regard to teachers, there are a lot of conversation exercises pragmatically focused on improving our communication skills, which includes making small talk, using role plays, expressing points of view, debating on different topic discussion speakings, and practicing group decision making activities. Let's talk about making small talk. The ability to make small talk is not something easily acquired. It demands a lot of practice, but when successful, it is highly valued. Making small talk means, of course, talking about almost anything and thus having a wide appropriate vocabulary covering most topics of interest, travel offers or tourism professionals. It is an important speaking activity leading to a gain of specific vocabulary and ability in coping with spontaneous circumstances. First, the teacher should choose a topic that might interest all the students and keep to it in order to get their involvement. Students, for example, students in geography of tourism are more likely to be interested in small talk about travel, food and catering, travel offers or tourism professionals. The second one is using role plays. The role play is a basic speaking activity focused on target structures, which the teacher provides by the use of cue cards, turning ordinary conversation practice into a mini drama and thus humanizing language teaching. It can be an excellent opportunity for students to launch themselves into extended interaction and a good way to develop fluency by focusing on the task in hand. The teacher should build up the atmosphere by asking lead-in questions as to warm up and engage students' interest in the specific situation and to set the context of their role play. The third one is expressing points of view. This speaking activity helps students express their opinions on a number of issues and explain their reasoning. The teacher should give points of view worksheet and ask them to rate their opinion from 1 to 10 on different statements from the student's field of interest. It is a dynamic activity involving, on the long run, a gain of confidence and self-assuredness of students expressing their own points of view or in making comments on other person's points of view. Fourth one is debating on different topic discussions. A debate is a form of argument based on several rules of conduct and arguing techniques. It is a more engaging activity since students need to develop concepts and to argue on diverse subjects, embarking in pros and cons and commenting on the arguments presented. This speaking activity is usually performed in a debating team, each speaker having specific roles during the topic discussion. And the next is practicing group decision-making activities. Group decision-making is a conversational task based on reflective thinking and brainstorming. This pattern of speaking activity is straightforward, presenting students with a range of decisions, each with several options to make a choice from. It is an excellent exercise for improving the dynamics and competitiveness with the class, students being asked to make a systematic approach to a particular topic and to generate as many ideas as they can within a structured framework for discussion. Now, here are some effective speaking skills. First, plan and organize what to say. Think before you talk. Identify your main points and then making sure that you may address them. Next is stick to your topic. Get your learner's attention. Announcing your intentions at the outset of your talk. Obtain your listener's interest. Present key points in a logical sequence. Use spoken cues to tell your listeners what is important and avoid jargon. Now, it's an important thing, how to develop speaking skills. To develop this skill, the students need intensive practice. Speaking practice is usually done in pair and group work. Now, what's the role of teacher in a speaking class? First is, oral skills can be organized to improve speaking as the task should be interesting for the learners as it gives purpose as well as direction. Second is, well-planned activities can be organized. Teacher has to see that each member of the group gets the chance to speak. Next one is, feedback session can be held wherein language errors are discussed and the correct forms are given to the learners. The teacher may even give remedial exercise to help correct the errors that come to light during the activities like role play, class, debate, narrating stories, radio shows, etc. Now, here are some things to remember, which is, happy is the hearing man, unhappy the speaking man. The difference between a smart man and a wise man is that a smart man knows what to say and a wise man knows whether or not to say it. Speak well and live well. Always think before speaking. Now, in the end, I would like to sum up my session by revising what we have studied today. Earlier, from the very beginning, we have talked about what is learning. Learning is a skill, tool for communication. We communicate with others to express our ideas and to know others' idea as well. Then we talked about language. What is language? Language is a set of human habits, the purpose of which is to give expression to thoughts as well as feelings. As learning of language is a skill subject, as every skill requires a practice, in the same way, teaching learning of English, there are main four skills, and that are listening, speaking, reading, and writing. Then we talk about our top 10 global fears: public speaking, death, spiders, heights, social situations, flying, open spaces, storm, small places, and the maximum percentage was of public speaking, and that was 19%. Now, then we talked about speaking. What is speaking? Speaking, speech is the vocalized form of human communication. Speech production takes place in real time, and moreover, it is linear, that is utterance by utterance. And planning is severely limited, therefore, it is the hardest of all four skills. Now, about speaking skills, we discuss about two major components of speech skills, that were motor perception skills, wherein the learner of a foreign language is exposed to sounds and structures of the target language, which the learner perceives, recalls and articulates in the correct order. And next was interaction skill. As a learner progresses through various listening speaking contexts, he or she begins to reach a level where the foreign language is merged as if were the situation, and the learner begin to think in the same language. Then we discussed about importance of speaking skill, and that was ability to convey our information in a proper way, ability to stand out from the rest, ability to benefit derivatively, career enhancement. Then we discussed about English sound system, in which we discussed that there are 26 letters and 44 sounds in English sound system, and these symbols have been given by International Phonetic Association, that is IPA. Then we discussed about English sounds which can be divided into two: vocal sound, vowel sounds and consonant sounds. Vowel is a speech sound in which the mouth is open and the tongue is not touching the top of the mouth and the teeth. There are five vowels, that is A, E, I, O, U, but there are 20 vowel sounds which have been classified as pure vowel sounds and diphthongs. Pure vowel sounds are 12 in number, whereas diphthongs are 8 in number. Pure vowel is a single vowel sound, and pure vowels are, which are 12 in numbers, are further classified into long vowels and short vowels. Long vowels are 5 in number and short vowels are 7 in number. Now we have discussed about diphthongs, and diphthongs is a combination of two vowel sounds produced as a single syllable. They are also called impure vowel sound because they don't have the purity of one sound. And examples have been given: toy, tour, poor. And English, there are 24 consonants in all. Then we discussed about voice and voiceless sounds, about phoneme, about syllable, about stress, about rhythm, and about intonation. As in intonation, the intonation is the rise and fall of pitch, which is called intonation. In other words, intonation is a variation in pitch. It is one by slacking or tightening our vocal cords and the sound. And in pronunciation, intonation is very important. And there are two types of intonation: falling intonation, rising intonation. In falling, we start with the loud pitch of voice and then voice goes down. And the pitch of the voice falls on the most important syllable. This type of intonation is definite and conclusive one. And about rising intonation, we discussed that it starts with a low pitch of voice and the voice then goes up. The pitch of the voice rises on the most important syllable. Then we talk about fluency, pause, and then we discuss about what does speaking involves. It involves appropriate vocabulary, expressions, correct pronunciation, correct word order, body language, tone, and facial expressions. Then we discuss why students make errors in English, making English pronunciation. Then there were many reasons we discussed. First was interference of mother tongue in speech habits, lack of exposures, lack of teachers, lack of attention to English pronunciation, lack of knowledge of intonation and stress, crowded classroom, and lack of curriculum emphasis on speaking skills. Then we have given many suggestions for good pronunciation, like opportunities should be given so that learners can speak, environment must be congenial, individual as well as chorus drill should be given, and English should not be taught with the help of mother tongue. In the end, and I would like to say that for a proper pronunciation, a good knowledge of sound system, stress, rhythm, intonation, fluency, and pause are needed. Thank you.